trace it back. They can do that pretty quickly, but again, the FBI, possibly even the Secret Service, would be called in on this to try to find out what's going on. Remember, it's a manpower issue. You need to get as many people as possible. Now, I can also tell you, Lisa, that Mayor Giuliani is supposed to speak very shortly. He's going to be speaking from Park Place and Church Street. That's fairly near where the crash site happened. The mayor will be speaking and telling us exactly what he knows up to this point.
Marcia, thanks very much. Jim Smith, are you still with us? Obviously,
yeah,
taking
Michael.
Pictures there. I didn't know if we had your microphone up. Can you talk a little bit about the flight rules and what you're used to seeing there in the way of flight traffic?
Yeah, Michael, first off, we can tell you that it was the south side of the World Trade Centers that were struck, just to give you some perspective. Those are the sides that face out towards New York Bay. Now, I have my pilot, Ed Baker, here with me as well to talk about what may have happened. Now, traffic flying through the area does not necessarily need to talk to the airports. However, it is most likely that they would have been in contact with the airport. That's if they were even contacting the airports at all. I'll ask, first off, Eddie, given the winds today, would this be a plane that would be approaching, taking off or leaving from either LaGuardia or Kennedy Airport?
This could very well have been a plane on approach to LaGuardia Airport. With the winds at this angle, they would probably be, if you were on the expressway and visual approach to runway 21, normally they bring them in over where the Mazda tanks were, and then they bring them on a downwind along the LIE. And boost to runway 21. So it'll be normal.
All right, so obviously we're having a little trouble with Eddie's microphone, but Eddie, given the flight pattern at this time, any planes landing at LaGuardia Airport would be coming over Queens and not over the Hudson River. Lisa, Michael, back to you.
Okay.
Jim, thanks very much for that update. If you can continue to hold the shot for us.
Mm-hmm.
Terry Shane is a witness, and as you look at tape of the second plane, making impact with Tower 2 of the World Trade Center, which just happened 18 minutes after the first impact, which was shortly before 9 a.m., the tape of this second impact happening 18 minutes later, shortly after 9 o'clock this morning. 40,000 people working in the World Trade Center. We don't know how many were in either tower at the time of the impact, but we do have joining us on the phone Terry Shane, who is an eyewitness to what's happened. Terry, good morning.
Morning to you, mate.
Where are you? What's your location? And what did you see happen?
I'm on Union Square, and I was facing the Twin Towers, you know, having my coffee on the balcony in the morning, and I saw this plane coming over, and I called my girlfriend to say, come and have a look at this plane. It's really flying very low. The next thing you know, I see the plane start deviating. It's sort of, you know, doing like a, not a victory wave, but, you know, a little bit of a left, a little bit of a right, and then it straightened out, and it just continued going straight onto the building, mate.
Oh. And your reaction, of course, was unbelievable, as is ours.
Well, you know what the crazy thing is? I grabbed my camera and tried to take some pictures of the plane coming in, and the camera did not work. The camera didn't work anymore. I couldn't believe it.
Terry, I was unable to hear you a moment ago. Did you make any comment regarding anything you've seen on the ground in that area?
Well, I couldn't see nothing. I can't see the ground, but I can see the two towers very clearly from where I am. And you know, the impact of the plane itself onto the building, it seemed to me as if it went straight through the entire thing.
Right, sure. Again, thank you, Terry.
Thank you.
You're looking live from our Chopper 2 and from multiple cameras around at two planes that have crashed into both World Trade Center bombings, number one first, shortly before 9, number two about 18 minutes later. Debris is drifting over Brooklyn, about 3 miles from Trade Center building number one, according to witnesses. And of course, seeing all that thick black smoke, Michael, harkens back to, of course, the World Trade Center bombing of 93 that killed 6 people, injured more than 1,000 others.
Now, we do expect the mayor to be speaking shortly. Let's go back to the newsroom and Marcia Kramer, who's monitoring the story from there. Marcia?
Well, Michael, although we have no word about whether this is a terrorist attack or not, we do know, Channel 2, CBS 2 has learned that the FBI offices across the country, from one end of the country to the other, have been put on high alert. What that means is that they are going to protect all federal buildings all across the country, all landmarks and all monuments, not just here, but in Washington and other places across the country. Again, FBI offices across these United States have been put on high alert to look out for any similar instances. We have to repeat, however, that there's no indication at this time that it was a terrorist attack, but what they're trying to do is to make sure that they have all their bases covered. They're trying to sort it out, to find out whether there was a terrorist involvement or whether it was some kind of fluke accident where, for example, the radar system at Kennedy and LaGuardia Airport may have gone down for a brief period of time. Again, the FBI offices across the country are on high alert. Federal buildings, landmarks, monuments, synagogues, mosques, things like that are being guarded to make sure that they are being protected and there are no further incidents.
Investigators clearly look into all possibilities. We certainly don't want to lose focus of the potential here for casualties, and there obviously could be very, very many. Marcia, can you tell us again what hospitals in the area are doing and what they're saying right now as far as how many they're expecting?
Well, I can tell you that New York Beekman downtown is the nearest hospital, so that'll probably be a place where they triage patients. But again, there's so many people that could possibly be injured or even affected by this that they're going to have to probably call into many of the hospitals in New York City. The nearest trauma center would be Bellevue Hospital, which is on the also on the east side, but they'll probably be bringing patients, depending on the seriousness of their injury, to probably all of the hospitals in New York City. I also want to tell you something else. In Sarasota, Florida, President Bush was reading to children in a classroom at 9:05 a.m. when his chief of staff, Andrew Card, whispered into his ear. The president briefly turned somber before he resumed reading. Asked what he knew about the plane, Bush replied, "I'll talk about it later." Here in New York City, again, though, the federal government has tightened security at all landmarks. We want to recap. Planes crashed into the World Trade Center, creating a horrifying scene. There is now no word at this time on casualties, but hospitals in New York City have all been placed on alert. They are expecting casualties. We don't know how many. And again, all landmarks, all FBI offices are on high alert. Michael and Lisa, back to you.
Marcia, thanks very much. We want to give people an idea of what area is affected. If you're unfamiliar and you're new or just visiting New York City, the World Trade Center is down there in the Financial District, just north of Liberty Street, south of Vesey Street, and west of Broadway. It's both Towers 1 and 2, as you can see from the live picture provided by Chopper 2. The first impact in Tower 1 happening just before 9 o'clock this morning. The second impact that we had shown you videotape of not too long ago.
Actually live on our cameras here.
And we were able to provide that image for you. The second impact, though, happening about 18 minutes after the first impact, and here's another look at it on tape. Hard from our angle to tell what type of plane or to really discern anything from that other than the obvious. Mm-hmm. So we're continuing to contact the FAA as well as the Port Authority, mm-hmm. all airline carriers. We've heard reports that the FBI now investigating possibilities, we want to emphasize, of a possible hijacking. Mm-hmm. And
or suicide mission, that's also a possibility mm-hmm. that we're being told is being looked into.
All reports from the Associated Press as well. We understand that George Bush, the president who was in Florida speaking to children, as Marcia mentioned a moment ago, when he was notified of what had happened, is scheduled to speak sometime soon, as is Mayor Giuliani.
Right.
The Associated Press only reporting that the FBI investigating, as is their job, any possible evidence of foul play.
Okay. Of course, it's difficult to find out information because the Port Authority is based at the World Trade Center, and Marcia Kramer's been trying to get in touch with them and get the latest for us. She's got a little bit more info for us from the newsroom. Marcia?
Well, Lisa, there is now word that the Port Authority has closed all their bridges and tunnels coming in and out of the city. What that means is the George Washington Bridge is closed, the Lincoln Tunnel is closed, the Holland Tunnel is closed, and all airports are now closed. That's regarded as a security measure. Remember, when you take a look at the possibility of terrorist attack, our bridges and our airports and our tunnels are regarded as prime targets. So to make sure that there isn't any other further disaster, they are closing all the bridges and tunnels into New York City. So to repeat, the George Washington Bridge, the Lincoln and Holland tunnels are closed. All three area airports, Newark, LaGuardia, and Kennedy airports, are closed. Now, in Washington, the FBI was said to investigating reports around 9 o'clock, just before the first crash, of a plane hijacking. That's something that they're going to have to be looking into to see if the plane that crashed into the first World Trade Center building, Tower 1, was in fact a hijacked plane. The way the city and state and federal officials are reacting is as if this was a terrorist attack. All of the FBI offices around the country have been placed on high alert. They are guard. They are.